My name is Jason Peters. I'm out here with Grid Magazine in front of the Germantown Community Fridge with its founder, Jane Ellis. Jane, talk to me about the Community Fridge. What do we have here? Why is it here? And what can people expect?
Hi, Jason. Thanks for having me. Mm-hmm. All right, so we have our Community Fridge here. Honestly, it's a fridge for the community. It provides free food. That's the fridge over there. And then we also have a pantry section where people can put non-perishables. And then the red box in the middle is just for volunteers who check on the fridge twice a day to make sure that everything in there is edible mm-hmm. and to just kind of clean up and, yeah.
To people who may not know what a community fridge is, what would you tell them about coming here for the first time or getting involved or even just taking stuff?
Sure. So it's a free 24/7 fridge. It's run by the community. It's for the community. So anyone can come up here, take whatever they want, and they can also leave whatever they want to. It's 24/7. No one's ever watching it or like saying you can't take anything. And our motto is for all the community fridges, take what you want, take what you need, and leave what you can.
Okay, so we are out in front of the Greene Street Friends School in Germantown. Why is it here specifically?
I'm actually a fourth grade teacher here, and my head of school and the school was gracious enough to let us host the fridge. Mm-hmm. So we got an outdoor outlet installed, and the school pays for the yearly electricity cost, and then everything else is run by community members.
We had mentioned that you're a teacher, and the fridge is in front of a school. Have you seen any extra need for something like a community fridge with specific food insecurity for students or the effects of COVID ramping up food insecurity?
We have a lot of great community businesses and organizations that are local that are helping to contribute to the fridge on a weekly basis. Mm-hmm. And two of them are actually a charter school nearby, and they still give out meals bi-weekly to their community members for kids who aren't showing up for school right mm-hmm. now. Their families can pick up meals, and any excess that they have for families who don't pick up, I actually go and pick it up from the school, and I'll put any extra meals into the fridge, which I think is pretty neat.
Okay, where did you guys get your actual physical fridge from?
I actually got that from my husband and I bought a house, and that's the fridge that came with it, and we just donated that one and got a new one for our place.
Okay, so how long has the fridge been running, and what inspired you to set this all up?
It's been open maybe like a month now, since it was open on September 26th. And I think I was just inspired by a lot of the other people in New York and LA who started it first. And mm-hmm. I came across it on Instagram, and I knew Germantown had a tight-knit community where people would help out to build all this and get it set up. And especially with COVID, you know, I feel like food insecurity is rising, especially in Philadelphia. Mm-hmm. And so it felt like a really, really good time, and the community showed up.
What kind of food can people expect to see at the Germantown Community Fridge?
I would say apples, milk, water, a lot of canned goods usually come through, mm-hmm. rice. It's really, honestly, it can be anything. I had someone DM me this morning and ask if it was okay to drop off his quail eggs.
Mm.
And he was like, can I leave a note just saying, I know most people don't eat it, but can I leave a note saying like how you can use it and some recipes? And I was like, yeah, sure. I think that's great for the community.
All right. Is there anything like specific do's and don'ts with the community fridge? Like things that you specifically do not want people to bring?
The only thing that we say don't bring is raw meat, mm-hmm. Just because it has a chance of contaminating the other food.
Yeah.
But if it's like cooked or if you throw it into the freezer, it's perfectly fine. And we do ask that if you make homemade meals to just like label it in case anyone has allergies and things like that.
Is there anything that you think people should know about the fridge that they may not know?
Honestly, Germantown is such a great community. Everyone, this is my first time dabbling in mutual aid or mm-hmm. any community organization outreach. And I did it straight through Instagram, and people reached out to me and they were like, I would love to help you paint. I would love to help build this shed. Like,
yeah, you guys have a whole shed set up.
Yeah, and those are things that I don't have the skill set for. So people in the community have totally showed up, and they've given the idea of the volunteer box. We had Mural Johns come to do the Black Lives Matter murals on the mm-hmm. side doors. So it's really been a community effort. They're the ones who show up to check on the fridge. They're the ones who take from the fridge, and they're the ones who drop off.
Well, how can people get involved? How can people get in contact with you to learn more about the fridge, drop food off, or do anything that you guys would need?
Sure. Right now we're trying to get our Facebook set up, but our Instagram is at Germantown Fridge, and I usually give a lot of updates on like what's in the fridge in the mornings and at night. And then we also have an email address. It's germantownfridge@gmail.com. And that can lead you to a volunteer form if you want to be one of the volunteers who checks up on the fridge.
All right. Well, thank you very much. It was great talking to you, and I appreciate you talking to Grid Magazine.
Thank you.